Looking for life on Mars isn't as simple as just looking for life on Mars. There are environments to consider, and it turns out rustier might be better. Hey guys, Amy with you on DNews today. Our planet isn't the same all around. There are different environments on Earth that affect the life forms that grow in an area. And the same goes for Mars. There are different environments around the planet. This is a good thing because it means there are multiple places to be looking for life. But at the same time, it also means that astrobiologists studying the planet need to narrow down what makes for a life-harboring environment. Gale Crater is a good place to start. That's where NASA's Curiosity rover is currently roving around. Not only is there a 3-mile-high stratified mountain in the middle of the crater offering a look at Mars's geologic history, the area shows evidence of past water and atmospheric methane, two things that speak to past life. But this evidence of water and methane isn't enough. The cells that make up any organism need energy to function, and that energy can't come from nowhere. So the question is, where on Mars might those energy sources be? Are there places on Mars where possible organics could get their energy? Green rust might be an answer. We're all familiar with rust, that lovely orange-reddish corrosive thing that happens to iron metals when left exposed to moisture and oxygen in the air. But when there isn't enough oxygen to fully oxidize the iron minerals, say in Mars's carbon dioxide-rich atmosphere, the effect is slower and develops into less complete forms of rust called green rust. Green rust is uncommon on Earth, but not unheard of. It's been found in waterlogged soils, groundwater, and in 2012 it was discovered in the oxygen-free waters of Lake Metano in Indonesia. This rare and highly reactive iron mineral played an important role in ancient oceans. Its presence in oceans suggests it was instrumental in removing nickel from ancient water sources, a critical process for some life forms that use it and the dissolved nutrients it carries to produce methane. And it's possible that, on Earth, green rust exposed to early atmosphere would have done the same thing, helping our planet generate the oxygen-rich environment that has harbored life like us. So what this means is that these two types of iron minerals have different redox states and different numbers of electrons, which could allow the mineral to take in or give up electrons to act as a catalyst. Green rust can absorb and concentrate nutrients as well as accept and donate electrons for life. Because Mars' surface is highly oxidized, it's possible that green rust exists just under the surface, which means we'll have to dig to find it. Some scientists want to try to detect green rust using Curiosity's laser, measuring the spectroscopy of the scattered light. But upcoming missions, namely NASA's InSight lander and the European Space Agency's ExoMars mission, will have the provision to drill into the surface. But we also need to learn a little more about this rare green rust and how it can possibly support habitability. So are you guys going to look at the rusted bits on your cars a little differently now? Let us know in the comments below. And want to know more about Mars? We just launched our first ever DNews spin-off show, Test Tube Plus. Check out the series where our very own Trace explains everything you could ever want to know about Mars.
Space technologies, they make everything better. Every dollar we put into space research comes back to us multiple times over in a variety of other ways. I mean, cordless tools are a side effect of space technology.
And of course, for more DNews every single day of the week, don't forget to subscribe.